Hey, it's FHRC Brony. I'm back again with another video. Now, since I already made my video of me driving the HPI Nitro Savage, I'm going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to give it a score, but I'm going to do it DougDeMuro style. First of all, if you guys don't know who DougDeMuro is, he's a guy who reviews cars, and since he had a new scoring rating, I'm going to give it a Doug score. Geronimo! Before I start giving the Nitro Savage a Doug score, I'm just going to tell you something in advance that my version of the DougScore is going to be a little different than DougDeMuro's DougScore. So, let's get started. Starting off with the Celestial category, which measures attention to enthusiast. Beginning with the styling. I do like the style of the HPI Nitro Savage, but it's not as really that good compared to like a Trax T-Max, so it earns a 6 out of 10. Acceleration-wise, for the HPI Nitro Savage, it's somewhat okay, but I had to drop it down to a 4 for one simple reason. When I gunned the throttle on this car, it was kind of like lazy to get up to its speed, but once it did get up to its speed, it did go 35 miles per hour, which is pretty good, but I had to drop it down to a 4 because of kind of a mediocre acceleration. As far as handling goes, the HPI Nitro Savage is somewhat okay, but it's still kind of mediocre upon steering inputs. Basically, what I'm trying to say here is, when I turn to the right, for example, it takes like a split second for the car to finally turn to that direction that I want it to go. However, when it does turn, it does redeem itself to give it some turning. It has an okay steering radius, so I'm going to give it a 5 out of 10. But what about cool factor? The Nitro Savage is big and huge, burly, and stuff like that. So I'm going to give that a 7 out of 10. And finally, last but not least, for the Celestial category, is importance. Honestly, I'm kind of biased between this and the Traxxas T-Max. The Traxxas T-Max looks a lot more better to me, and I think it looks more reliable compared to this one, because I have to do a lot of work with this car. But however, it is pretty good, but so I'm going to give that a 6 out of 10. Add those points together for the Celestial category, brings up a total of 28 points. Now we're in the Lunar category, which measures features and content, quality, durability, and value. As far as equipment and features goes for the HPI Nitro Savage, it's pretty much straightforward. The only thing that I really like about this car is it's the metal frame on the side and the Nitro engine that it is equipped with. It's equipped with a 4.6 CC engine that's actually a lot bigger than the Traxxas 3.3s. I give it a 7 out of 10. As far as quality goes, there's really nothing much to say considering the fact that it's an 8 scale and it's huge, so I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10. As far as durability is concerned, the HPI Nitro Savage lives up to its name. It's strong, it's pretty much bulky. It feels like something that I would not mess around with when I'm doing jumping and doing everyday bashing, because this thing can really take a beating. Compare that to my Slash, that thing will just annihilate my Slash as far as bashing goes. Well, obviously my Slash is a 10 skill, but like, I've been driving my Slash for quite a while and it really lives up to its name of being, you know, a good basher, but the Savage really lives up to his name. So that's going to give it a good 8 out of 10. And last but not least, for the Lunar category, is value. I did research on the HP and Nitro Savage, and I take a look at the prices, and they said that they're asking for about $500 for this car, considering the fact it's an 8 scale and it's powered by Nitro engine, which is okay with me. But I certainly will not buy it. But for some of you guys who really want to get this car, it's pretty good value. So I'm going to give it a 7 out of 10, bringing the total Lunar score for 30 points. And that brings a total Doug score of 58 points.